In this class, we'll discuss about Smith chart. Smith chart is one of the important topic of transmission line. Now, if you remember, when we are dealing in the transmission line, we have to find something called as input impedance, reflection coefficient, voltage standing wave ratio, or the length at which you will have voltage maxima, the length at which you have a current maxima, right? All these problems we have already dealt with. Now, in order to solve all this problem that has, it may happen that your load impedance is complex, the computation will be complex, right? So it will be actually a tedious job doing all those things and finding out. Smith chart provides us a method to solve all those things, and we can get all those things in a graphical way, right? So it is one of the easier way of doing that, right? We'll go back to the Smith chart and we'll see how the Smith chart is useful in finding all those things, right, in the future videos. Now, if you talk about Smith chart, the Smith chart has two things. The first thing is it has something called as constant resistance. It has a constant resistance circle and constant reactance circle. So it has two things, constant resistance circle and constant reactance circle. Okay, so we'll see what is a constant resistance circle and constant reactance circle. Let's see that. This is how the Smith chart will look like. We'll go back to the details of this, but let's try to identify what is a constant resistance circle and what is a constant reactance circle. Okay, now if you see here, if I look here, there are some circles, right? This circle of 4, right? This is nothing but 3. So these are nothing but circles, right? This is another circle. This is a circle of 1.2, right? These all are circles, right? This is 1. This circles, which I am drawing right now, is called as constant resistance circle. So this circles are something called as, and it will keep on going. This is what is called as constant resistance circle. Then one should ask, what is a constant reactance circle? Let's see what is a constant reactance circle. So we'll rub this. Now, if you observe, there is something here also. These are also circles. Right, even in the down also, right? This circles is called as constant reactance circle. So this is what is called as constant reactance circle. Okay, so we have identified the Smith chart has two things. One is constant resistance circle, another is constant reactance circle. We also said like why it is useful, because it make our life easy, right? Because solving those things numerical or theoretically, it's very difficult. Solving need calculator and other things. Graphically, it is very easy to solve all those things. Okay, now let's proceed on Smith chart and see what else is there in the Smith chart. If I come here, I can see there are something written here, which is saying that wavelength towards the generator, right? And that's an arrow mark. There is something written here, wavelength towards the load, right? So this is something, it is saying that wavelength towards the generator, and there is something called a wavelength towards the load. Let's understand what do you mean by this. Again, what we can say that, if you remember the normal transmission line, which we used to draw. So let's say this is ZL and this is your Z0, right? Now what happens is, if you're starting your measurement from the load point and if you're moving like this, so if your reference point is the load and if you're moving towards this line, then we say that this is nothing but moving towards the generator, right? This is what you're moving towards the generator. But if your reference point is still with generator, and you are moving towards the load, this is what is called as moving towards the load. So there are two things, moving towards the load, moving towards the generator, right? The same thing they are saying here. So either you can measure moving towards the generator or you can measure moving towards the load, right? How much length actually we are moving in a Smith chart? Let's see that. Let's have a look of that. If you see here, I'm more interested in moving towards the generator, because that's how we have solved in a numerical, right? So this is my starting point. This is how I'm moving, right? If you see, it is 0.07, 0.08, and this value is keep on coming, and here it is 0.25, right? It means half of the semicircle, it is nothing but 0.25. It means in a one complete circle, if you see here, it is 0.49. It means taking one complete circle in a Smith chart, I am moving a distance of lambda by 2. This is very important, right? It means when you are completing one circle in a Smith chart, right, you are covering a distance of lambda by 2, right? Which is, that's how it is saying that. Somebody may ask, if I have to cover a lambda distance, or it nothing but if your transmission line, or let's say that somebody may ask like this, this distance is equal to lambda. It means your length of the transmission line is lambda. How you will cover in the Smith chart? The answer is very easy, right? If one circle in the Smith chart is giving you lambda by 2, then you make two circles in the Smith chart so that lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2 will give you lambda, right? As simple as that, right? So whatever the distance, you can go into that multiples of this and you can cover that length, right? Okay. So we have understood what is this. Another thing important to note here is, if you see, there is something called as angle of reflection coefficient is also given. We'll see what is the importance of angles of reflection coefficient when we'll be solving a problem using a Smith chart. But you can see that already the angle of reflection coefficient is also given to us. Now, let's see that how we'll deal a problem, or not a problem, how the things will be plotted, or simple impedance will be plotted in case of Smith chart. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to draw the simple transmission line. So let's say that this is my transmission line of characteristic impedance, let's say Z naught, okay, and load impedance as ZL. Let me give some values, arbitrary value. I'm giving some value here as, let's say that 50, okay, and I'm giving this as 50 plus 100J. This is what I'm giving. So my load impedance is complex in this case. Now, if I go to the Smith chart, none of the value, if you see here, it is nothing but 1, 2, something. If I go here, it is 5, right? This is nothing but, if you see that, it is 1. Again, this is 1.2, it is 1, 0.9, 0.8, 0.7, right? And if you see here, 0.5. None of the value is 50 or 100, right? So how I'm going to deal with that? So that is del is nothing but, in your transmission line, or in case of Smith chart, everything is plotted in terms of normalize. It means if you want to plot your load impedance on the Smith chart, you have to plot something called as normalized load impedance. It is nothing but you take your ZL, so this is nothing but your normalized load impedance will be nothing but your ZL divided by your characteristic impedance. Right. So what would be the value in this case? It would be nothing but 50 plus 100J divided by 50. So this comes out to be how much? This comes out to be 1 plus 2J. So it means you have to plot 1 plus 2J, which will be nothing but the normalized load impedance of this circuit. Let's see that how I can plot 1 plus 2J. Okay, let's go back to the same. So my purpose is to plot 1 plus 2J, right? So can I say that this 1 is nothing but the resistive part, right? And this 2J is nothing but my imaginary part, right? Or nothing but, this is nothing but the resistive part and this is nothing but your reactance part, right? So I have to find the circle or the resistance circle which where the value is 1, right? So it means if I go here, what is this? This is nothing but, you see, this is 2. 1.8, this is a 1.2, this is nothing but your circle, which is nothing but 2. This is a circle belongs to 1.8 value. This is a circle belongs to 1.6, 1.4, 1.2. So this is the circle, right, which is nothing but at 1, right? So we have to find the resistance value as 1, right? So this is the circle, which is 1, right? So I have identified the circle is this. Okay. Now, what is the imaginary value I have to look? I have to look for 2j, right? If I come here, this we know that it's a reactance part, right? What is the value here? It is 1.2 circle. It is nothing but this is 1.2. This is 1. This is nothing but your. This is nothing but your 0.9. This is your 0.8, right? That's how. So I have to find 1.2, right? So this is what is 1.2, right? Sorry, I have to find it out. I have to find it out 2, right? This is 3. Can I say this is the 2? This is the circle which is making, which is nothing but the constant reactance circle of 2, right? Okay. So I'll rub this part. So I know this and this are the two things. Now I have to find the intersection of these two circles. So if I continue this circle, the resistance circle, it will go like this. And the reactance circle will come like this, right? So if I draw more clearly, it would be nothing but there will be an intersection at this point, right? This is what is my intersection, right? And this will be what is called as ZNL or normalized load impedance, which is nothing but 1 plus 2J, right? So we are able to find it out the load impedance on your Smith chart. We are able to plot that, right? So we have understand more about what is a Smith chart, what is the purpose, and how to plot the impedance on the Smith chart. In the next videos, we'll see how to solve a problem using a Smith chart.